हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू अवर ज्योग्राफी क्लास। आई होप यू सीन माय लास्ट वीडियो ऑफ सेकंड लेसन ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, एंडोजेनेटिक मूवमेंट। द नेम ऑफ सेकंड लेसन इज एंडोजेनेटिक मूवमेंट्स। वेरियस नेचुरल इवेंट्स ऑकर ऑन द अर्थ फ्रॉम टाइम टू टाइम, दैट इज फ्लड, स्टॉर्म, स्नोफॉल, एक्सट्रीम रेनफॉल एक्सेट्रा। सिमिलरली बिकॉज ऑफ द मूवमेंट्स बिलो अर्थ सर्फेस, नेचुरल इवेंट्स लाइक अर्थक्वेक एंड वोल्केनिक इरप्शन ऑकर। For the organism living on earth, these events are disasters. There is loss of life and property because of natural calamities. In this lesson, we will get introduced to this endogenetic movements. Endogenetic movements means internal movement on the earth. In last video, we complete our some points: slow movements, landforms, fold mountain, block mountain. Now start the next point is Rift Valley. Our next point is Rift Valley. In block mountain, we understood the when a part of earth crust in between two parallel faults is lifted, it looks like a block. Such landform is known as block mountain. When a part of earth crust in between two parallel faults, is lifted, it looks like a block. Such landform is known as block mountain. For this, try this student. Take three notebooks of the same size. You take three notebooks of same size, hold them on tightly fixed on a table, keeping a distance of 2-3 cm. Remove the two notebooks from three. First we told you, take a three notebooks. Remove the two notebooks on each end away from the central one. Observe what happens. Draw the diagram emerging because of notebook in your own notebook. Here student, complete our next point is block mountain. Now start the next point is Rift Valley
and block mountains. Now let us learn about the third feature, that is Rift Valley.
Sometimes two fractures develop side by side in the earth crust. The land in between the two fractures subsides. The subsides deep part is called Rift Valley.
Rift Valley. To understand the concept of Rift Valley, let us do an experiment. For this, take three notebooks and hold them tightly on the table, keeping a distance of 2-3 centimeters. Then, move the two notebooks on each end slightly away from the central one. Now, observe the effect of this action on the notebooks. On observation, you will notice that when the three notebooks were held together, their upper surface looked flat and even. But when the notebooks at the ends were moved, the notebook in the...
See, here student, you try to do this in your, at your house.
Center also moved in the downward direction. Hence, the upper surface of the structure became uneven. The central notebook looks lower as compared to the notebooks at the ends. Such a feature, when formed on the earth's surface, is known as Rift Valley. From the experiment, you must have got an idea as to how a Rift Valley is formed. Let us now learn about it in detail. When the movements on the earth's interior are in the opposite direction, the rocks in the earth's crust are subjected to tension. When the tension increases, sometimes fractures develop side by side in the earth's crust. The land between two adjoining fractures subsides. Such an area of subsidence is called Rift Valley. Both the slopes of Rift Valleys are steep. The Rift Valley of River Narmada in India, the Great Rift Valley in Africa.
Student, when horizontal movements on the earth's surface act in opposite direction, it causes tension on the rocks in the earth crust. Did you see here a practical? When tension increase, fracture develop in the rocks. This leads to formation of faults. Consequently, rocks on both sides end slide and calamity. Continuity in the layers of rocks is not found. The Rift Valley of River Narmada in India, the Great Rift Valley of Africa, the Rhine River Rift Valley of Europe,
and the Rift Valley of River Rhine in Europe were formed in this manner. So this was the information regarding the mountain building movements. Now, let us learn how continents are formed due to slow movements. Continent building movements or epirogenic movements. Slow movements occur either towards the center of the earth or away from it towards the crust. Due to such movements, an extensive portion of the earth's crust is uplifted or gets subsided. In this process, when the part of the earth's crust is raised above the mean sea level, continents are formed. These movements are known as continent building movements.
Continent building movements. What is continent building movements? Slow movements occur towards the center or from the earth's center towards the earth's crust. Slow movements occur towards the center or from the earth's center towards the earth's crust. Because of these movements, a vast part of earth's crust is uplifted or gets subsided when a part of earth's crust is uplifted. Uplifted means above the mean sea level. Continents are formed. Therefore, these movements are called continent building movements. Extensive plateau can also be formed because of such movements. If the originally continental portion of crust subsides below the sea level, it forms a part of seabed. Slow movements occur towards the center or go from the earth center towards the earth crust.
Such movements can also give rise to the formation of extensive plateaus. But if due to these movements, the original continental portion of the crust subsides below the sea level, then it forms a part of the seabed. Till now, we discussed about the slow movements in detail. Now, let us study about the sudden movements.
Now, we start sudden movements. Sudden movements. In the beginning of the chapter, we have discussed studies the news atom on earthquake. Powerful earthquake rocked Nepal, nearly 1,500 killed, Nepal devastated. So students, here in the beginning of the chapter, we have discussed the studied the news atom on earthquake. Earth means ground and quake means trembling. Earthquake is a movement of earth crust. You have been acquainted with the magnitude and effects on earthquake through the activity at the beginning of the chapter itself. Now we will look at the sudden movement called earthquakes and volcanoes in the earth interior in detail. Here student, we understood the first in our lesson, Nepal devastated. Powerful earthquake rocks Nepal, nearly 1,500 killed. The initial report said tremor measured 7.9 magnitude. It is the quake hit at 11:40 a.m. local time at a shallow depth of 11 km.
At times, there is a large scale and sudden release of energy in the interior of the earth. As the speed of these movements is high, these are called sudden movements. These movements take place in a vertical radial direction. These movements are highly destructive. We experience their effects in the form of earthquakes and volcanoes. Let us now learn about earthquakes and volcanoes in detail. Earthquake. Earthquake is a natural calamity. In the term earthquake, earth means ground and quake means trembling. Earthquake means the movement Earth's crust. Due to the movements occurring in the interior of the Earth,
I give examples, Mr. Rand. When you stand around railway platform near a railway track, you experience trembling if a train passes by speedily. Tremors are also felt when a heavy vehicle crosses a bridge in speed. Through these examples, one can estimate the tremors caused during earthquakes. Now here we understand the earthquake definition because of movements occurring in the interior of the Earth, inner side of the Earth. Any movements, tremendous tension is created in the Earth crust. When the tension goes beyond limits, when the tension goes out of control beyond limits, the energy is released in the form of waves. This result is trembling of the Earth surface, that is earthquake occur. The magnitude of the earthquake is measured by Richter scale.
Crust is subjected to huge amounts of stress. When this stress exceeds a critical limit, the energy is released in the form of waves. As a result, the Earth's surface trembles. This trembling of the Earth's surface is known as earthquake. Every day, you must be reading the news in the newspaper or watching it on the television, or you must have heard elders in the house discussing about various topics. Likewise, I will now show you a news article in the newspaper. Read this news carefully and answer my questions. Tell me, what caused the large-scale casualties? Correct! The large-scale casualties was caused by an earthquake. When did this event take place? Correct! The event took place on 25th April. What was the magnitude of the earthquake and at what depth was the focus located? Absolutely correct. As per the news, there were two severe tremors of magnitude 7.9 and 6.6 on the Richter scale. And the focus of this earthquake was 11 kilometers deep inside the Earth. Always remember, the magnitude of the earthquake is measured in Richter scale. Now tell me, which country was the most affected by this earthquake? Correct! Nepal was the most affected country by this earthquake. Where was the epicenter of the earthquake? And which are the other affected areas? The epicenter of the earthquake was located in Lamjung, Nepal. However, the tremors of this earthquake were also felt in India, Bangladesh, Pakistan, etc. What kind of damage is seen because of the earthquake? Correct! The earthquake caused heavy loss of life and property in the affected areas. According to you, what could be the reason behind the earthquake? Correct! The instability created by the internal movements of the Earth can be the reason for the earthquake. Now tell me, have you ever experienced a similar earthquake? No? Okay. To experience what happens during an earthquake, I will suggest you a simple method. Visit a railway station near your house and stand on a platform. When a train passes by speedily, you will experience trembling on the platform. You can also experience such tremors while standing on a bridge. When a heavy vehicle crosses the bridge speedily, we can experience these tremors. These tremors experienced on the railway platform and bridge closely resemble the tremors experienced during an earthquake. But now you must be wondering that the news in the newspaper reported heavy losses due to the earthquake. But the tremors experienced on the railway platform or on the bridge did not cause any damage. What is the reason behind this difference? To understand this, let us do an experiment. For the experiment, arrange the notebooks in this way on each other. Then place 3 to 4 objects like chalk, duster, sharpener, eraser on them. Now quickly take out a notebook from the bundle without affecting the other notebooks. Observe what happens. We can notice that due to the action of quickly taking out one notebook from the bundle, all the objects placed on the structure fell down. Now, again, arrange the notebooks and keep chalk, duster, sharpener and eraser on them. Now, give a slight push to this structure and observe what happens. Now again, give a hard push to the structure. Observe what happens. Now, we can notice that when the structure was pushed slightly, the objects placed on it were merely shaken. However, when a hard push was given to the structure, all the objects kept on it fell down. That means, depending on the intensity of the movement of the notebooks, the effect on the objects kept on them varied. Similarly, depending on the magnitude of the earthquake, its effect on the surface of the earth varies. The magnitude of an earthquake is measured with an instrument called seismogram. A seismograph can be drawn with the help of this device. By studying this graph, we can find out the magnitude of the earthquake. Now, using the latest technology, modern earthquake measuring instruments are created. With the help of these instruments, earthquakes having low magnitude can also be measured. For example, electromagnetic seismometer. In this, with the help of an electrical instrument called galvanometer, the magnitude of an earthquake can be measured more accurately and with higher sensitivity. Thus, we learned about the various characteristics of earthquake. Let us now learn about the various causes of earthquakes.
Causes of earthquakes. Moving of the plates, colliding of plates, plates sliding one below the other, forming of fracture in rock layers due to tension in the interior of the earth, occurring of volcanic eruption. Now we are complete our some points, students. Rift Valley, continent building movements, sudden movements and earthquake. Next part of lesson is next period.